Hello once again, this is part 3 of my Tama unboxing video, which has kind of turned into much more than just that. Unboxing video of the Tama Imperial Star bop kit. And I'm going to set up my drums again here, and I just wanted to give another little demonstration here of something that I just really think these things are so cool. Nobody makes these anymore, except for like maybe one or two like small drum makers. And they're ridiculously overpriced, in my opinion. But it is the Canister Throne. This one I got is not in the greatest condition, but it's functional. And it still looks pretty cool. It's vintage, there's no brand on it. But you'll see here, if I open this up, I have all of my hardware contained within. And I'm gonna set up my drums, and now what's in here, I finally got my new hi-hat stand. Everything is flat-based, except for the snare stand, but it's a lightweight Ludwig snare stand. But what you'll see, I have my Speed King pedal. Take that out. I have my newest addition here, this Olympic hi-hat stand, which is really, really cool. I'll show you this a little bit more in a minute. Hopefully you can hear me over the music. I'm listening to the Ventures here in the background. This is the top part of the hi-hat stand. We have my Ludwig. This is a Ludwig Rocker 2. Before, I think on my last video I didn't mention that. But this is a lightweight hi-hat stand that came out before. There is a company online that is still selling these. They have some old stock. And that's Steve Weiss Music. So if you want to pick up one of those, they still do have a couple of those on there, and they're not too expensive either. We also have two of these Ludwig flat bass stands from the early 2000s. That's what I use for my cymbals. I actually am just using a single Crash Ride right now, so I have an extra one here. But I don't know, if I want to do two cymbals, I have other cymbals, I can do that. So I actually even have an extra stand in here. And then I have my tom mount. So that's all my hardware, and this entire set of hardware in the case weighs probably about a third of the total weight as my old hardware and old case. So that's just really, really nice, actually. So yeah, that's it, and I'm gonna start setting up the rest of my drums, and maybe I'll show a little bit of playing again. I'm not sure. Maybe I'll just show you the drums, but thanks for watching. Okay, just one more quick video this time. Not going to do any playing today, just because I want to play and actually practice and not worry about playing on a video, so I'm going to do that instead. But anyway, here's it all set up, and she's all complete now. I have all the stands that I wanted. There's the flat-based Olympic by Premier hi-hat stand, made in England. I would say it's probably 50s or 60s. It's really, really cool and in amazing condition. And it actually, you know, I wasn't sure how stable it would be, but it seems pretty good so far. I've been playing for about an hour, well, not an hour, about a half an hour. And so far, so good. It hasn't slipped at all. And, you know, it's not, of course, it's not like a heavy-duty modern stand, but I don't know. I think if you control the way you play, you can use a much lighter stands than people think you can. And I'm not like a light hitter either. You know, I hit pretty hard, so you know, I don't bash, but I do hit pretty hard. But yeah, so light stands, like I have the light snare stand. The thing is, on the first video, I mentioned that the Speed King worked fine on the bass drum lift, and I was wrong. It actually doesn't. So what I did is actually, if you see, there's a piece of bass drum felt folded up and just put on there, and that keeps it pretty stable. I'll probably work on a more permanent solution to that later on. But for now, that's working. And I'm not sure why it worked in my house. Maybe I just didn't test it or, you know, hit it hard enough, or just, I don't know, it seemed like it worked, but it really didn't. So this is it. The heads, I have vintage A's on the toms and on the snare. And then on the kick drum, there's the stock Tama head that came on the batter, which is actually pretty nice. I like it. And then on the front, I have a vintage Emperor with a felt strip as a muffle. There's nothing inside the bass drum at all other than that. So yeah, there it is. Tama bop kit, hairline blue finish, super stylish, super vintage looking if you have it set up right, with like, stands from the era and all that stuff. It really looks like an old kit, and it's really cool. I really love it. Anyway, thanks for watching, and subscribe if you like this kind of stuff. I post all kinds of music videos. Take it easy.